If you need to match positive and negative numbers to each other, then this is a way to do it. So what we've got here is some data. You'll see there's a whole bunch of negatives, the creditors, and then down here there's the positive numbers, and they're all Amex listings. So the first thing we'd always do when we do this, sometimes the sort order is important. You may have dates, etc. So we would just make sure we can always get back to the sort order. The way we do that is just create an index. I've put a 1 there, that plus 1. I'm just going to copy it down, paste it. And then because I know I'm going to do some sorting, I'm just going to highlight it, copy, and paste as values. So now we're not worried. We can do what we want, sort, and we can always get back to it. And the problem with negative and positive numbers is it's quite hard to get them next to each other. So we're going to use a function called ABS. And point it at our mount. And all that does is it just removes the negative sign. So now when I copy it down, we now have the negative number, but also we've got the absolute number. And I've got another column here called notes, and you'll see why that's useful. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the whole area. Just make sure you get the whole thing. I'm going to put my filter on. And now what we can do is we're going to sort based on ABS. So I'm going to go and I'm going to actually say sort largest to smallest. So what you'll see is it sorts it. And notice, immediately we can start seeing some items matching. So if I look at the first one, there's a negative 169,000. There's no matching item. So I'm going to just put a note here immediately saying check that one. I can then see these two seem to match. Their reference number seems to match. So maybe I can put a note. I'm just going to say the word matched. Here again, this one doesn't seem to have a partner. So we might say check, no partner, check. And so you can continue. And then you may get to some of these. You can see there's two negative with the same amount. And then a positive. We don't seem to have any reference numbers. So this one you might need to check properly because maybe there's been some double counting. So you can see I can paste it. And you can then continue to work through and match what can match using all the references or whatever knowledge you have. And when you're done, you can either filter and pull out the ones to check. But most importantly, I can then go back to my original sort order, sort smallest to largest. And we're now in our original sort order, but my notes are still there. So what needs to be checked, what has been matched, etc.